there's obviously a lot of hullabaloo, let's say, over Deputy Prime Minister Di Maio meeting with the yellow vest protesters. But why can't he, especially if they share the same ideologies?
Well, because it's a provocation too much, because Luis Di Maio must think, exactly as you tried to say, that he's a vice prime minister of a country. And the vice prime minister of a country, of Italy, cannot spend all his time to search the provocation against a country which is an ally with which we have a shared interest as France. So I think that this is really stupid. It is a stupid attitude which just goes badly against the interest of our country. That doesn't mean that a political leader cannot have contact with other political movements, but a political leader, when represent a government, cannot permanently looking for an external enemy to hide internal problems. And this is exactly what Di Maio is doing in the case of France, in the case of Emmanuel Macron.
Yeah, but then what about the comments made by Matteo Salvini? He made a very precise point that France has also been rejecting migrants from its border. He gave the number of 60,000. Has he not got a point in that respect, that France is also being hypocritical in this issue?
Well, I would be very worried of the numbers which gives Salvini, because he said that there were 600,000 migrants expelled from Italy, and he expelled 3,000 in this year. So, I mean, be aware of the numbers during the electoral campaign of Matteo Salvini. But of course, I mean, this is another stupid attitude of our government, because France, unfortunately, is applying rules, Dublin rules, asylum rules, which are against the interests of our country. And basically, what does the Italian government do? Does it strike alliances with those like Orban from Hungary, or Kaczynski from Poland, who do not want to change those rules, and open conflict with France, with Spain, with Malta, which I would be interested in changing these rules. So, I mean, this is another hypocritical and contradictory attitude. And after all, the ally of Salvini is Marine Le Pen. I wonder whether Marine Le Pen would like to welcome more refugees from Italy to France.
Well, Matteo Salvini has tried to strike a more conciliatory note. Do you think this is going to die down? And also, do you think that France has probably acted probably a bit too strongly when it comes to this row?
No, I think that it's a provocation too much, also because not only emit a movement which has been violent, but meet the most violent part of the movement. And that happened after the Di Maio encouraged the Gilets Jaunes, the most violent Gilets Jaunes, to go on. You remember when they crashed into a ministry in France? Well, the same day, the vice prime minister of Italy, of another country, said, please go ahead, continue. So, I mean, I think that simply the meeting with this gentleman, which is famous to be an Islamophobe, famous to be a violent like Chalençon, was the provocation too much. And I do not think that the vice prime minister can meet someone who says, the enemy of my enemy, i.e. the enemy of Macron, is my friend. This is simply doesn't go in the interest of our country and doesn't go in the interest of France, of course. Italy and France have got common interests. That doesn't mean that we must always agree. Yet we had important rows in our government.